Hello, this is Emma with a very beautiful head of hair you may recognise. This is my cousin, Nicole. We made a video together about 2 years ago, and since then, it's been very highly requested that she come back, and she's with me for a few days visiting. So here we are in the Tingle Shed. And this time, we're going to do something very similar to the last video, but this time with some little extras. Something you haven't seen in a while if you've been following the channel for a while. First thing we're going to do is brush the hair and remove any knots on the ends. Mic on the brush. And then in some oil treatment, but this time this is a mixture I made myself specifically for repairing hair after a cold winter. I'll tell you more about that in a moment. And once we've covered the hair and we've given her a nice scalp massage with the oil, we will cover her hair up with this. This is a shower cap. Keep all the heat in and make sure that the oil penetrates into the hair and the scalp and warms up, soaks in and works as well. So, brush. We don't have too many knots in, so I'll just start at the ends very gently. And then I shall be able to go from the top. And then uses a lovely wide paddle brush, and the teeth are very smooth to minimize damage. Nice and wide apart so they don't pull the hair. Cole's hair is a little bit shorter than it was before, and it's super long now, so it was so long that we're not able to get all of it on camera, this close up. It's lovely and thick. It's also a little bit lighter. Okay. So, the homemade oil. I'll pop the recipe description for you, but this is specifically to nourish the scalp and the hair, soften the hair, nourish from root to tip. I'll keep shaking this up. As it separates, I mixed some argan oil for nourishment with avocado oil, which is moisturizing for the scalp and nourishing for the hair. There is cider vinegar, apple cider vinegar, and the reason for that is that it strips the hair of buildup, so any buildup from shampoos, different products, that will remove everything. And the other ingredient was rosemary essential oil, and that's also very nourishing for the scalp. Okay. So I'm going to need Nicole's help for this bit, because she has so much hair that we thought it'd be best if we sectioned it off, and then I was able to distribute the oil more evenly. And this happens to be a salad dressing bottle, but I thought it would work quite well for this job. Let's see. Okay. So, our first section, when you can. Thank you. That's it. You can see here that some of the oils have just formed up together, so I'm going to spread those out. I'll concentrate more on the roots first, and then distribute it over the ends next. work it through. So that's all the way to the ends, and then we go for the next section, and I think probably about three should be enough. Set. Set. Lovely. Pour again. I may put some on my hands too. In fact, I'll do that first. Okay. I think that once the hair is covered up and warming up nicely and all of the oils are soaking in to the scalp and the hair, I think about 15 minutes to half an hour would be a good time to leave it. Longer if you can. Depending on how dry your hair is. Our main issues in the winter, or the main issue in the winter, is central heating for drying out the hair. And then, of course, in the summer, we have the sun. So, a treatment every now and again powders for your hair. Okay, and just a little bit more. Make sure it's all the way through this side. It's probably not the best bottle to use, maybe a smaller one would be easier. It's really easy to spread. I'm more or less pulling it through all the way to the ends. And the next layer, you can probably rest your arm in a moment. So. So much hair. And we didn't actually have holding it for me. Okay. And then I'll pop a bit on my hand as well. And then the last layer. Lovely. And I think I'll pop it on my hands. So with this recipe, you can use avocado oil, which is what I used, or you can use half of an avocado and blend everything together. It would probably end up a bit thicker if you used an avocado, so it's worth experimenting. Once it's in the hair, it just completely sucks through anyway. Some more on the ends and run a little bit more through, and then we can massage it into the scalp, which will be nice. Once it takes hold, it just soaks right in. Thirsty hair. Okay, and now we're going to do the head massage. And work all of these ingredients into the scalp. Some more on my hands. Okay. One last brush through before we pop on the cap. And this brush is fine to use when the hair is damp like this, because the bristles are far enough apart. Very smooth. But it's important to just use the right brush so that you don't get any damage. And now I shall just roll the hair up and pop it inside the shower cap. It twist you could hold it. And warm that up. And the heat from Nicole's head will stay inside the cap Warm up the hair. Warm up the scalp. And all of those I think we'll leave this on for about 15 to 30 minutes, like I said. And there we are. I hope you enjoyed watching that. Take a nice picture.